Hello and welcome to the Askit Developer Screencast. Today I want to show you how to use the block diagram editor in an Askit project. To create one, you have to select a folder in your Askit project, right click, say new Askit block diagram. This opens the wizard. You can give a name for your block diagram class, MyBD for instance. This opens the block diagram editor. An ESDL file has already been created with a class called as MyBD. And now you can start modeling on the canvas. The block diagram editor has a palette with various sections. The first section is elements, so you can select, for instance, a variable, click, drop it on the canvas. You can give it a name, myvar. If you select the variable, the properties view below shows you the properties. You can change the type, for instance, here is real. You can go ahead and say I want it to be a boolean. Now let me create another variable, var2. To make a connection between two elements, you just click on the source, drag, and click on the target. On doing this, you get a sequence number on the canvas. So this class has a method called as calc. And this is the first line of code which is going to be executed. The block diagram editor also has on-the-fly validation, so it's checking for errors already. The error marker tells you that you have a Boolean type which is being written to a real type. That is not good. So to correct this, I go to this variable and change its type back to real. And it's gone. Let me save it. In the imported element section, you can add elements to your canvas which are not defined in this class but elsewhere, like public variables, tables, etc. So here is a message button. If I click on it, this opens the message selection dialog. From here, I can also multi-select. Let me take two messages at the same time, drop it on the canvas. Then I take a send message. Choose message 3. In the basic block section, you have all kind of elements so that you can do some operations. For example, addition, subtraction, then you have logical and or comparators and more. So you can take a plus operator. You can also change its properties here. Then make connections. And that's it. So the block diagram editor has an outline view. It shows you all your elements which are being used in the model currently. And here there is an error marker. It says that because I'm using messages, and messages are supposed to be used only in static classes and thread annotated methods. So how do I fix this? I select my class. In the properties view, activate the static class flag, then I select my method and enable the thread annotation option and save it, and with that the error is gone. Then there is a third palette section called as control flow. So here I have if else, a while, and a switch block. So I can take, for example, let me take this operation. We can also do copy paste, so Control C, Control V. And I want this to be a minus. You can change it here. Then I take an if else. Then I take some variable, call it some condition, and of that nature, Boolean. And I connect it to the if, and if it is true, I want the plus operation to be executed. If it is false, I want the minus operation to be executed. Then there are also structure blocks. So for example, a container and a statement. So what does it mean? As your model grows bigger, You don't have enough space to draw on the canvas, so you can also create sub-diagrams essentially. So you can take a container, you can drop it here, you can give your container a name, do something, and you can select the container, you can say it has an input and it has one output. You can also resize it and then connect something to it. Let's connect this message here, let's create another variable and connect it here. There is an error marker because there is no operation happening inside. Double clicking opens the container. In the outline view, you have your pins. So let's drop the pins on the canvas. And now let's just connect it. You also have a breadcrumb bar which allows you to navigate back faster. So you can go back to the parent easily. You can also drag a signal to the container and it automatically creates a pin for you. As you can see here, it created a pin with the message 2. And I can take this pin, also now use it here. Let's get rid of this and let's do something like this. Okay. That's a container block. Now, the block diagram editor has also a sequencing view which shows you the assignments in your block diagram editor and in which order they are executed. So you can see here, var2 is the first line of code, then you have the if condition, and then you have the assignment to the variable v. You can use the sequencing view to rearrange this, so you can drag and drop it. And then V becomes the first line of code. You can also use direct edit on the canvas, so you can select the sequence number, press F2, and let me make that back as the third assignment. It is also possible for you to create new methods, so you can select your specification, create a new method. In the new method, let's add some arguments, so you can create an argument, let's create two arguments, and there's a return. You can change the property of the return here. I also want it to be real. Then drag and drop your arguments on the canvas and do some modeling with it. So let's add these two as well. Good. All right. So there are many more things which are possible. It's all documented in our online help. And additionally, we ship a lot of examples for the block diagram. So you can go to File, New, Example, and then you say Ascet Modeling, Block Diagrams, click on Finish. And then there's an example for many use cases. So for example, subcomponents.bd, it shows you that how you can from your block diagram class use classes which are defined elsewhere, for example in a system library. So I have here library blocks like edge rising, edge falling, integrator, for instance. That's all for this screencast. Bye bye.